Hello viewers, it's so good to be back again with yet another inspiring story. My guest today is an awesome, awesome person, and I'm sure many of you are very keen to know who he is. He is Major Devinder Pal Singh, and what's so special about him? He's a Kargil war hero. He got injured at the Kargil war. He nearly lost his life. He was 28 kilos when he was rushed to the army hospital, and everyone gave up hope. And yet, there was just one doctor who said, let's give him a chance. He survived, but then he lost his leg. And thereafter, his journey has been incredible. He's the first blade runner of India. Very inspirational, isn't it? And that's Major DP Singh. Hello, Major DP Singh. I'm so happy to have you in my show.
Welcome. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind. So, Major DP, tell us about this incredible journey of yours. You joined the 7th Battalion of the Dogra Regiment in 1997.
Yes,
and you graduated from the Indian Military Academy. And thereafter, I think immediately you were sent to the Kargil War in 1999.
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't it? So tell us about the initial army life and what was your motivation to join the army?
Army is the only dream which I saw as a child. I had spent my childhood in Roorkee. And I studied in Kendriya Vidyalaya Roorkee.
Very proud to be from Kendriya Vidyalaya.
So I have stayed with my grandparents from second class onwards.
Right.
And I feel that is something which had shaped up my foundation to be whatever I am today. Although as a kid it was very challenging because my grandparents were not that pampering type grandparents.
Right.
So away from my parents all through the life and not so pampered lifestyle had taken the toll on that child during those days.
Right.
To the extent that if I share with you, in 8th standard I had run away from home.
You did, from your grandparents' house?
Yes.
Oh my God.
And I wanted to go to my maternal grandparents' house.
Okay.
Because that is where all that pampering and all that love and affection was in air. Whatever you could do, you know, whatever is your wish. The only thing which I knew was that from my house, the bus takes us to that place and it reaches by evening if we start in the morning.
Okay.
And this is the road which goes there.
Mm.
So I thought, let me start walking, maybe in 2-3 days I'll reach there. So that small child, you know, maybe in innocence or whatever, I had already walked out of the, you know, outer limits of my city when somebody known saw me and he asked me, where are you going? And without answering, he made me sat on the bicycle and he dropped me outside my house.
Mm.
So that was the first U-turn of my life.
Okay.
Because while coming back, all those, you know, mind was working and all those thoughts were striking me that what exactly I was trying to do.
Mm.
Maybe I wouldn't have even, couldn't have reached anywhere. Mm. You know, it's so foolishness for me.
Mm.
Maybe somebody might have just picked me up
mm.
and then made me put to use by making on menial types of job, you know, washerman, cleaning,
coolie,
or whatever.
Mm.
So is that the life which I am supposed to be living?
Mm.
And that's the day when I decided, no, I will stay here only and I will fight out all, you know, so-called that childish challenges which I had.
Mm.
And I'll prove my worth. That what am I? And that U-turn only gave me the insight that what should I be doing in the future? And that's when, you know, perhaps the seed of joining army was sown. And it got nurtured further because by virtue of being living with somebody who is one generation behind.
Right.
And they're carrying the value system of that generation. So they connected me to the religion. By virtue of being a Sikh, when I became a regular visitor to the Gurdwara Sahib, I understood the teachings, the value system, the traditions, and the ethos of Sikhism, which is full of nothing but sacrifice, service towards other, martyrdom for the nation, you know, heroism, sacrificing the whole family for the sake of others. So all these values got inbuilt, and then when I was, you know, somehow correlating it, I realized that armed forces is nothing but the same.
Same thing. You know, any metal has to go through fire for its brilliance to be shown. So I guess your childhood, your early years spent with your grandparents who gave you tough love, kind of gave you that foundation which made you not only a person that you are today, but also relate to people who probably passed through similar situations.
Absolutely, ma'am, because you know, one very small things which I tried inculcating during those days, small things like, you know, on Doordarshan we used to watch TV, so I used to see that who, you know, the old time movies of Raj Kapoor, where even he had always, you know, live up to, for others, you know, khud ke liye jiye to kya jiye, tu jiye dil zamane ke liye, and such stuff.
Yes.
So, all these small traits I used to admire and try to pick up from there, that what is the good human values. And you know, these small daily efforts have converted the thing into something what I am today.
Very inspiring, isn't it? So I'm going to be back after a very, very short break, hearing more about what happened to him during the Kargil war in 1999. Stay tuned. Welcome back, dear viewers. I am in conversation with Major DP Singh. So, Major DP, when you woke up in that hospital where you nearly lost your life and reality stuck, you know, as in what had become of this beautiful body of yours, how is that agonizing? I mean, I'm sure you do not want to go that route, but then a little bit of that journey when you woke up and felt everything was gone.
Well, this is again, if I say generic preconceived thought that it must be agonizing. But to tell you, it might be surprising for you, I never felt anything bad.
Okay.
Because, of course, many of my boys I lost during that war. So I also got injured. And injury is a part of game of the armed forces. So what big deal? Yes, I was a little surprised when in that small hospital of Akhnoor, the doctor visited me when I became conscious. And, you know, his statement was that I'm the only one in the ICU that time.
Okay.
A very small hospital. And the doctor visits me and tells me that, that lucky you are that I have come on a round, because I can see your toe is getting affected by gangrene. And I was thinking that how can he say me lucky? I am supposed, it is his job, you are supposed to be taking round.
How did you let the gangrene happen?
But anyway, that's the part of game. And it was on third day of my hospitalization there when they found that the gangrene has occurred in the foot. On the right toe of my right leg. They evacuated me further to the Udhampur, Command Hospital, Udhampur. And it's only after reaching in the Udhampur hospital when the bandages were opened of the right leg. And as I could see that there is nothing left, only a shin bone which is visible from on the top and some amount of flesh downside. So, any logical person can make out that taang to kategi. But the doctor was very kind, and Colonel Ashok Kumar, retired as a Major General later, he was mustering courage by coming on one side of the bed or the other side of the bed and looking and, you know, inspecting the wound very deeply. And of course, you know, I could make out ki ye to jaane wali hai. And some moments later, he shared the news that, son, and his exact words were that, son, we need to impute your leg, but we'll try to save as much as we can. And I reacted back, sir, I can see there is nothing left. So please go ahead and do the thing.
Oh my God, you said that. See, you were so you knew this was to happen?
Of course, when it is supposed to happen, is there any point crying over it? But that moment, you know, as I mentioned, maybe during the childhood onwards, I was getting shaped up for something like this.
So devastating. Yeah, right. A normal human being would have, I think, broken down, yelled and cried and why me, God kind
Well,
of
I will
situation.
Not say that I am an abnormal human being or something risen or something like that. But then, of course, I feel that I am the chosen one who got not only shaped up by seeing some tough life during the childhood, but also by virtue of Almighty's blessing who gave me the positive perspective to look at the life. And today I feel that I am living much, much better life than what I could have lived otherwise had I not got injured. Mm. So for me, injuries is the best thing which could have happened in my life. In fact, I jokingly thank Mr. Musharraf, General Musharraf, that had he not made that bomb which was thrown for me, I wouldn't have lived so beautifully.
Tell us a little bit about that moment in 1999 when this incident happened.
So, no heroism, nothing big like what we see in Bollywood and what many more, you know, my contemporaries and my brothers in arm have done in their life. Nothing I could do. I was deployed on that small post, commanding around 30 men under me. And my post was 80 meters away from the enemy post.
Right.
And the LC was running in between. And my post was on a riverbed. So, one thing which I, of course, know that I was a little pain in ass to the enemy because I used to keep fingering them from one side or another. I remember on one corner of my post, I used to mount on the self-help bunker's roof. In front of that, I still had 4.5 feet of wall in front of me. And from there, I used to stand and aim their bunkers with a air burst rocket launcher ammunition. So one day while I was doing that, I could see the other soldier from there is firing a rocket launcher and I am also firing, and he had fired by then. And I could see that ammunition is coming towards me, but I had few fraction of seconds to take my action and complete my action. And I did that. They don't have the airburst ammunition, right. We do have.
Right.
And my ammunition must have, you know, devastated them. His weapon which was fired, the round had hit right in front of my wall. Okay. So, I could get the chance of firing and sitting down to save myself from that. So, this is the type of, you know, nuisances which I had created among them, and that's the reason perhaps they were looking at a pot shot me only to, you know, hatao isko yahan se. And that is where the lull happened in the war, and they planned perhaps. I was not so mature, hardly put in 1 year of service. With lot of nonsense type of activities which anybody...
And too much of adrenaline in the blood. Kuch karke dikhana, I'd have to do something.
So, you know, but that is what changes the war scenario. If you feel that you can put mind behind the fighting out, it doesn't work out like that. It's only passion and blind passion which makes us win war.
Absolutely.
Maybe because of this only we lose so many young blood who get martyrs every other day. But that's the type, it has to be like this only. So this, you know, mortar bomb was fired upon me after a lull of 48 hours. And it was aiming me only because, you know, in war zone you can make out that the if an ammunition is fired, it will land behind you or further, you know, in
ahead.
Front of you. But the one which may land next to you, don't come to know the noise of that. You can't make out. So the one first round was fired, landed quite far behind me. The second one landed with some correction next to me only. And it was 1.5 meters away from me.
Oh my God, just 1.5 meters.
Yes, ma'am. But the killing zone of that mortar bomb, as per the teaching, is 8 meter dia.
Oh my God.
So within 8 meter dia, if somebody is there,
they would die.
They would die. But as on
US
this
saved,
also. On this also, I joke around that, you know, wo bolte hai na ki every bullet carries somebody's name.
Name on it.
So when they couldn't find the bullet on which my name was written, they had fired a weapon which is like to whomsoever it may concern. And they even wasted that also.
That wasted. Oh my
Thanks to my boys, I must mention them. It is because of them today I am alive. My boys picked me up without worrying about their own life. And this is what the best part of
the brotherhood.
Yes.
Of the army. Absolutely, absolutely. My God, I still have goose pimples on me. Stay tuned, viewers, because I'm going to be back very, very shortly hearing much, much more from such an inspirational war hero. We'll be back very shortly. Welcome back, dear viewers, to the Dr. Renuka David Wellness Show. I'm in conversation with Major DP Singh. So, Major DP, tell me about your determination to be this India's first Blade Runner and how, you know, that kind of not only changed your life, but changed so many lives around you.
Well, I would say there was nothing like this that I wanted to become first Blade Runner or something. It is something, the journey which started from that thought, you know, that maybe someday I will live a life, then it faded away. Automatically, Almighty made me to walk on a path where I saw that there is a need to do some action which can prove that disability is related to having body parts or having less mobility or stuff like that. Because enough of gyan and seminars and conferences must have happened by then. Mm-hmm. I'm talking 2009 when I ran my first half marathon with the artificial leg. Mm-hmm. But then what change it brought on ground? Mm-hmm. On ground change can only happen with action.
Yes.
And I saw various such facets of public, mm-hmm, and the ideas which were floating around, mm-hmm, that the disability and such life was related to bad karma.
Oh.
Right? So yeah. And on the contrary, I felt that if I am able to do something which conveys that I don't need legs to do something, you know. Mm. So I chose the most difficult part, to run long distance with the artificial leg, because the reason being again that something which people can't even dream in the Indian scenario, that person who doesn't have a leg can stand, walk or run for some distance.
Yes.
He can't go for long distance, nobody can dream.
Mm.
So if I do something like this, then I don't have to say anything. It will be my actions will prove that disability is nowhere related to this.
Absolutely.
So that's how I ventured into that arena. Of course, it was not an easy walk, because I was doing something which was untreaded till in the history.
Mm.
But then, you know, if your intent behind the action is correct, even universe conspires and support you. And that is what happened with me. I kept on walking on that path, and that initial supernatural thought made me keep doing things, and the support system kept on becoming support system in the sense that answers of various ways and means, how to do, what to do, what not to do, I kept on getting those answers by myself. Because I realized that it took me 10 years, and for 10 years I was knocking doors and asking how can I run with the artificial leg, and nobody could give me that answer.
You did that for 10 years?
I mean, of course, I was meeting the prosthetist, the artificial limb center, guys, and there was, as I mentioned, I had already promised that I will not compromise with the quality of my life. And when I say not compromising the quality, that means staying and doing everything which I was doing earlier, which includes running.
Absolutely. So you were looking for the right workmanship
that how can I run with the artificial leg? But when nobody could answer, I said, to hell with anybody, let me find on my own.
Okay.
And then when you have this much of passion to do something, then answers automatically comes.
They come.
And then gradually I realized that, you know, it is possible. I ran. Then as a veteran, I was given the first blade in India by the Indian Army. You know, this is the beauty of Indian Army. As a veteran, I was given the first blade in the history of India by the Indian Army.
Wonderful.
And then I started running on blade, which was again a very difficult story. Because running with the blade gave me a lot of injuries. Now again, I say the perspective towards life is to be clear. I had the choice when I got profusely injured after my first blade run. My skin got peeled off at various places on my stump. It was swollen, it was totally full of blood. So of course, in such situation, the most easiest choice is to let it go now. No more running. But then is that something which I was supposed to be chosen to be the first Blade Runner? I don't think so. I felt that perhaps if I am being the chosen to move further and progress better in life, I should find the answers of it, to come out of the injury status. And then I innovated various ways and means. Again, nobody was helpful there. People can't help because they are not aware about it. So somebody has to take the lead, and somebody who takes the lead need to do it on its own. So as a one-man army, I was able to do it, and automatically some answers, you know, came to my mind. To the extent that when I was invited to US by the best of the prosthetists in the world, his name is Kevin Kirol. Even he was surprised because my level of amputation is such difficult, which is through the knee amputation, for which making a prosthesis which fits better and comfortable is most challenging thing for any prosthetist in, of the world. And what he mentioned is that with this level of amputation, there are rarely anybody in the world who goes for a long distance run. But then that's why I am the luckiest one. That's why I am the chosen one.
Major DP, you did this only for yourself, isn't it? It wasn't for anyone else.
Well, I see that I just did it. Myself or anybody else, I don't know. I just wanted to do it and I could do it. Now, all these are byproducts, you know, getting inspired myself or others getting inspired or my actions are inspiring. It is something I can't put a statement to it ki maine uske liye kiya ya khud ke liye ya kisi ke liye kiya. You can't do something like that. When you are in thickest of action, you just do it.
But then you did it for your happiness because you promised yourself.
Of course, that is there. That you know, I was not able to take it lying down ki yaar possible nahi hai. Aise kaise?
You had to do this.
So when there is a challenge, of course somebody need to answer it.
Absolutely.
And whenever there is a challenge, it proves the person whom that challenge has been given, that he is for sure is being the chosen one to rise further in life.
Major DP, my final question would be, especially to an audience where, you know, any negativity in their lives, whether it is illness, whether it is misfortune, whether it is probably their professional life not doing as well as it should do, they always, you know, are either they try and they do not succeed, or they just give up. And what would be your strong message to people like this, you know, who go through not as, you know, extreme challenges the way you face, but people who face challenge which seem beyond their control? So what would be your message based on your personal life to these people?
So the first thing which I would submit here is that somebody who has been thrown into a challenging situation, you know, please shift your perception towards other side and look at it that means you are chosen for something better.
Right.
See, it is like only a student who clears 8th or 9th ka exam can go and sit for the board of 10th. So there's a progress of the student when he passes the lower level, then only he can progress further.
Absolutely.
So if there is a challenging situation in front of you, that means you are the chosen one. You are the student who are supposed to be progressing further, but only when you pass the test. Now, how you pass the test as a good student? By imbibing all the things which are required to pass the test and improving yourself, or by taking shortcuts, avoiding and seeking sympathy or getting into the negative zone. Your next result is all related to how you nurture yourself. So choice, of course, is yours. You want to avoid an outskirt? Life is a tough teacher. Life will not leave you till you learn the lesson of the challenge which you are undergoing. The more you delay, the more tough it will become. Because you are the chosen one. And the early you accept this, that you are the chosen one, and you need to now get geared up and learn all the tricks and trade where you can improve yourself further. Because only once you fill that gap of progressing further, you can go and sit for the board exam of 10th. Look at it from that perspective and everything will be simple. In fact, you will start seeking challenges. Okay, let the challenge come to me because I need to progress further. And who don't want?
And finally, you'll make everyone feel that they are disabled compared to what you are there rightly sitting and saying so.
Well, of course, disability is altogether different perspective. If I ask viewers Do you know cooking? I'm sure 50% of them will say no. If I ask them, do you know driving? Again, 50%. So if you are not able to cook or drive, that means you are disabled in that.
Absolutely. Very well said. True.
It's a perspective.
It's absolutely a perspective. It's been such a pleasure, Major DP, to have you on my show. And I'm sure hearing your incredible journey and the way you fought back so bravely is going to be an inspiration not only to my viewers, but I'm sure it's just going to spread around not only India, but also across the world. Thank you so much for being in my show and continue doing the great work that you're doing.
Thank you so much. I would seek your blessings to stay humble, because that is the most important part on this journey. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind. So that was the amazing Major DP Singh, who shared his incredible story with us. I'll be back next week with yet another story, bringing two very, very inspiring people who are going to touch your lives. Stay radiant, stay blessed, have a great weekend ahead, and we'll see you very shortly. Goodbye.